Hello everyone, let's jump on to the next section of the video, which is the absorbable suture material. So in absorbable suture material, we will start with the polyglycolic acid. So this is a very So let's jump on to the next suture material, which are absorbable suture materials. So absorbable suture materials are very important to use in oral cavity, and these days mostly we prefer using resorbable suture materials only. So first in that category is the polyglycolic acid. Although we do not use directly much of the polyglycolic acid in the oral cavity, but it is important because it is the basis of is the polygalactic 910, which we are going to use in oral cavity a lot. So this is a synthetic suture material, absorbable. This is very important. Earlier we studied the non-absorbable suture material like proline, nylon, etc. Now we are coming to the absorbable materials, and it is a multi-filament structure. So the good advantages of the polyglycolic acid is that it has good tensile strength, very easy handling properties, very good knot tying properties, and very less tissue edema. And mostly it is used by the surgeons for the skin closures and for the abdominal and thoracic surgeries. In oral cavity, we do not use polyglycolic acid too much, but we are using a variant of the polyglycolic acid, which is polygalactic 910, which I am going to tell you in a few minutes. So the brand names are Dexon and Surgiclean. You just read it for the sake of the theoretical part, because if you know this, that these are the various sutures available, it is very easy to make the decisions. So let's see the next slide. Polygalactic 910, which is the Vicryl. So this is the most commonly used suture in the oral cavity. This is absorbable, this is synthetic, and this is braided suture. It is most commonly used. So it undergoes the enzymatic degradation, and within 3 to 4 weeks of its placement, the whole of the suture it gets weakened, and within the 60 days it gets resorbed. So suppose if you are putting the sutures in the oral cavity, we are supposed to remove within 7 to 10 days. So within 7 to 10 days, that means the sutures are not yet resorbed. So whenever you are selecting a suture, whenever you are conveying it to the patient that okay, we are putting the resorbable sutures material, mostly patient expect that it will resorb in its own. So you have to tell your patients, if you are using the Vicryl, that they are not going to get resorbed within 7 to 10 days, and they get loosened up within 3 to 4 weeks, and they get fully resorbed within 60 days. So I usually recall my patients after a few days, after 10 or 12 days, and remove the sutures myself if I'm using the Vicryl sutures in mouth. So you have to convey this to the patient. So for your own knowledge, you should know that for the 3 to 4 weeks, it gets weakened and it gets completely absorbed within 60 days. And it is very commonly, again I am telling you, this is a very commonly used suture material. Sometimes Vicryl and other polyglycolic acid sutures, they are impregnated, means they are coated. Like this is the suture, they are coated with a layer of triclosan. So triclosan is an antibacterial substance. So in mouthwashes also, there is triclosan present. So it acts as an antibacterial agent. So polyglycolic acid and Vicryl, they are coated with sometimes triclosan to make it resistant to the bacterial infections. And that particular Vicryl is called Vicryl Plus. So I use this Vicryl Plus a lot. This Vicryl Plus, you can see it is braided, coated, polygalactic 910, and violet is the color of the suture. And here you can see the color of the suture is violet. So this is again a synthetic suture. I am going to explain all these markings in detail after a few slides. So Vicryl Plus is most widely used suture material in oral cavity. It's a costlier suture. So everybody cannot afford that in their practice. If you want to use any kind of resorbable suture, you can use simple Vicryl also. They come in the range of, I think, 200 to 300. This Vicryl Plus comes in the range of 400 to 500. So as per your practice, you can choose what kind of suture material you want in your practice. So this is how the Vicryl plus suture looks like. This is the color of the Vicryl that we get in the packet. Even in the regular Vicryl also, we are getting the same colors. This is how this looks like. So there is another variant of the Vicryl suture, which is called the Vicryl Rapide. So it is basically the hydrolysis action or the resorption action is much faster. Okay, so it is made up of accelerated bio absorption. So areas where we need to remove the suture or we want that suture should be resolved within 7 to 10 days, this suture is the ideal suture. And we have to be very careful putting suture in those areas where we know that strength, the tissues will regain strength within 7 to 10 days. If you think tissues need more time to heal, you cannot put Vicryl Rapide over there. You need to put either regular Vicryl or Vicryl Plus. Okay, so this is a modification done in the Vicryl to give it a more accelerated bioresorption. So let's see what are the different markings on these suture packings. So as you can see, I'm starting from here. This is the manufacturer name. In this case, it is Ethylon. It can be anything. There are various companies which manufacture the suture materials. Then comes the needle shape. Needle shapes we are going to discuss in detail in the upcoming slides. So right now you can see needle shape is this is reverse cutting needle. This is the structure of the reverse cutting needle and this is how a needle looks like. This is the gauge of the suture. I have already explained the gauge. The more the number of the zeros are, the thinner is the suture. Okay, this is the needle coat. This is the needle length. Needle is 19 mm in length. Or 3/4 circle needle is. And needle type, reverse cutting. This is the image of the needle. This is the length of the suture. So this is 45 centimeter length which is there in the packing. Suture comes in 76 centimeter long also, even longer also, or even shorter also. So that depends upon what kind of procedure you are doing. Suppose you are doing continuous sutures, so you need a longer thread. You cannot really do it with like smaller thread. In between, the suture will be finished. So for continuous sutures, you have to take a longer thread suture. For interrupted sutures, you can choose either a longer one or a shorter one. For my interrupted suture, I usually use a shorter thread. And then once the suture is finished, I can take another one also. Because it is easier to handle the smaller suture. Then the suture length, then there is the expiry date. Whenever you buy suture or any medications or any stuff in your clinic, it's really, really important that you see the expiration date. And this is people don't know how to pick up a suture needle. So this is where you pick up a suture needle with the help of the needle driver. The needle is exposed that much. So you are going to put your needle holder over here and you are going to pull the needle out of this along the curvature of the needle and the suture will be out. Although the suture is wound against this proper in this packing in a reel form, but once you pull it, it comes out very smoothly without any entanglement or without any knot. And this is the type of the suture material. This is polyamide suture and this is everything that is written on the packing. What rest is written is these are the markings that you can see yourself. Do not reuse. This is a single use suture. Mostly sutures are single use. This is the expiry date. This is the method of sterilization. This is the ethylene oxide sterilization or radiation sterilization. And this is the batch number. These are the various markings which are present on the suture packing. And these are again one picture which shows you what are the markings on the suture packing. So there is one more suture material I would like to discuss, that is expanded polytetrafluoroethylene EPTFE suture. These are the recent sutures and very good sutures, and these are the monofilament. This is the chemical composition tetrafluoroethylene, and it's highly flexible suture and its mechanical qualities are extremely good. So it's very easy to handle. It's very extremely useful in the cases of implants. It's extremely useful in the cases of GTR, bone graftings, and the areas where there is a lot of possibility of the surgical edema. In that case, if you put PTFE, it is one of the excellent material, very good tensile strength and doesn't break. So although it is a very, very costly suture, but at least you should keep at least one in your practice, so that especially if you are doing implant cases, especially if you are doing bone grafting cases, so that you know that these are the sutures which will really hold your membrane or material or blocks very well together. So enough about this PTFE, because you cannot routinely use this PTFE material. These are very costly sutures. So in conclusion, I would like to say that for a non-resorbable suture, if I'm using a non-resorbable suture, then silk is my preference, which is a braided suture, multi-filament suture. Silk is my preference. And if it is a resorbable suture, then I would say Vicryl is my preference. I can use either Vicryl Plus, which is my favorite, or this is usually, and rarely I have used catgut. Yes, I have used catgut in the oral cavity, but I usually do not recommend too much catgut in the oral cavity. So silk, along with the silk, you can use the nylon also in the oral cavity, but again the knots are slippery, and knots are, you have to give more number of throws to the knots, otherwise it will open up. Slightly tacky to handle because it is very silky in nature and usually slips again and again, and very sharp thread, sometimes tear through the mucosa. But if you are, you know, managing between silk and nylon, I think most of your non-resorbable categories are done. So for resorbable, you can keep Vicryl in your practice. It comes in between 200 to 300 rupees, and it's worth the investment. So this is everything about suture material. Very brief idea. There are a lot of suture material, lot of the depth we can go into, but there is no need to go into those kind of details. We are mostly talking about the practical applications, which suture materials are to be used in which conditions, and how to give sutures effectively in the oral cavity. So let's see you in the next video. Take care.